Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode here on Pastiche of Skin of World of Final Fantasy. The World of Final Fantasy.
The World of the Final the Fantasy.
The World of Final Fantasy. Yes, we've got another episode here. We're going through another chapter. We just finished chapter 15, where we actually liberated Figaro Castle, which happened to have a Mako reactor inside of it, and was powered by Vivi and his friends, just giving their spirit energy like a goddamn spirit bomb from Goku. We've unlocked that place. We now are going to the land of Perpetual Night, or the land of the Stolen Sun, to find out where we can get the third key, which is going to lead us to the Crystal Tower at the very end of this game. We've got six chapters left. Let's keep on hammering through. We got introduced to a lot of interesting characters so far. I don't know who we're going to run into next, but I'm sure we're going to probably meet some more members of the League of S, which so far have included a lot of characters from Final Fantasy VII and Final Fantasy VIII. So I want to know who these people are. And of course, we need to go to the Big Bridge. And if anybody's a big fan of Final Fantasy, they know the Big Bridge is where the battle on the Big Bridge happens, which could lead to us fighting some very interesting characters. I'm hoping Gilgamesh or Yojimbo, but we'll see who we end up getting.
Ah, what a pain. Huh? Say, you wouldn't happen to be the giants from the hills, would you? Wow, perfect timing. You see, there's a little favor I'd like to ask of you.
Favors? Really?
Recently, the sandworms out in the Phantom Sands have been getting more aggressive and have started causing trouble for the merchants that pass nearby.
Really?
Normally, it's my job to go out there and deal with them, but as luck would have it, I did a number on my arm yesterday.
Okay, so you want us to just
go
and do it for you?
And stomp out that nest of wriggly invertebrates?
Sure, at some point. Picking up the slacker slack. Alright, so where do we need to go? We can go up this way. Should I have the VV for a second, actually?
Is there anything I can help you with?
Aww. Oh, buddy. I want you to be my summon. That's what I want. Not fair, man. I want little Vivi to be my little buddy friend that I can summon.
I can't stand it. Oh, I can't stand it. Why do those mirages insist on causing me trouble?
Okay.
You two. You wouldn't happen to be the giants from the hills, would you?
We would be.
You've come at just the right time. There are some horrible mirages I want you to reprimand for me.
Oh, reprimand?
Those thieving good-for-nothings have raided every single shipment of the luxury tea leaves I ordered.
So I'm assuming they're actually going to be bandits of some sort?
These are the despicable fiends that have been stealing my tea leaves. Be a dear and take care of this for me, won't you?
Five red captains?
Hurry
up
and take care of those mirages for me.
Okay, we're going to hunt those down. So this is our exit here. Alright, we need to go south. I was wondering there for a second.
Midgar seems to be down for a nice long sleep.
Midgar?
Midgar?
Ah, that's what the place is called. The underground facility you explored.
Huh?
Alright.
Why did you guys name your prison?
Well,
interesting enough.
It's not technically speaking a prison at all.
Huh?
No? Then what?
It's a hidden city?
This size? We never fill so large a prison. The men you met down there, those were my guards in disguise.
Dude!
Right!
I thought the guy's prices were a little too good to be true.
If I might explain, Figaro's submerging castle has always been in my family. But I was the one who discovered the facility 10 years ago, while trying to figure out how the castle ticked. Excited, I enlisted Shinra's help. We investigated, and discovered that the facility was called Midgar, and powered by special energy known
Midgar
as
Midgar and Mako.
However, not only was it teeming with mirages, the machines that Shinra was using for the investigation, they developed a mind of their own and attacked us.
Okay.
There were too many threats down there. Not to mention it housed my moving castle's power source. And so, of course, I needed a good cover story that would keep even the Federation away.
Pretty good story to come up with, really, to get them to stay the fuck out, but, yeah. Can we leave now? How do I leave? I would like to leave. There we go. There is the leaving door. There's a door we can leave from. Fabulous. So where am I meant to be going? Alright, well, I'll just go this way.
Once more, we wander into the desert region and search once again.
Chapter 16.
For the clash on Big Bridge.
Clash on Big Bridge. So Big Bridge, it's off to the west, right?
My first colossal crossing. This is gonna be colossal crossum.
Now I'm getting
the colossal crossum. Oh God, just the comedy in these sometimes. Do you want? I'm just gonna hit a Billy's here. Can I actually joyride any of these? Balls. So I've still got to keep running. That's disappointing. I thought I might have actually been able to jump on a ride on my Magitek and actually get the boop, 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 boop. You know, like the actual music from the beginning of Final Fantasy VI. Holy crap!
Whoa! That thing over there has got to be it!
No!
Holy
that
sweet
is one
Jesus!
The bridge! Well, you sure can't say it doesn't live up to the name!
Yeah, that's a big motherfucking bridge! Does it have an elevator? Thank God!
Getting to the top is
going to be murder.
All the same.
Still, you have to admire it. Who could have built something like this?
Nobody ever built
it. A titan?
A giant summoned it here in ages past.
Oh, it's her! Eco. Eiko. More Final Fantasy 9 characters.
My job is to look after the bridge.
She's pretty cute. She's adorable. She was adorable even in the original game. Like she kind of looked about this size in the original game as well.
You were saying that Big Bridge isn't man-made, that someone summoned it here. But like,
first, the bridge has a real name. It's Alexander, in fact.
Right.
The Great Mirage, Big Bridge Alexander. Oh, it's the true. How did I then miss it? I can sense
so
the bridge.
Alexander is actually a bridge. Dude, in this one.
This
fair
thing
play. It used to be a castle.
Holy schlep.
And that's why a summoner like me has to look after him.
Wow. So you're a summoner then.
Yeah, but it's
do you know
not
Yuna?
Like I'm the one that summoned him. Hey, can I ask you something?
Hmm?
Are you them? The one and only giants from the hills?
Of course.
Yeah. That's the word.
So, I guess that means it's true.
What is?
Hmm? Wait a second. If the prophecy is right, you better not even think about it. Don't you dare lead us down the wrong path.
We'll pick one along the way.
So
we'll be fine.
The Azure prophecy, it very clearly says you could bring us salvation or ruin, the divergent futures.
Oh, that's right. Princess Sarah did tell us about the divergence.
Wait, the what?
You're the mean you forgot? I'm starting
to worry. Of course
he
has.
Maybe I shouldn't let you use the bridge.
Hey!
Oh no. We're cool. Me and Rain are totally going to wreak the right future.
Sure are.
Huh?
Hmm.
Well,
Alexander believes
you.
It's
not like I can stop you. The prophecy's about you, not me, right? Go on, you can cross. But don't go causing the apocalypse.
Yeah.
Duly noted.
We'll do that on Tuesday, but we'll have it fixed by
so
Thursday before the parents get back. We'll be fine!
To get to the tippity top of Alexander? Just get on. I'll handle the wake-up call.
The what?
Okay.
Alexander's kind of a sound sleeper. So it's my job to step in and sort of get things going. Now, off you go!
Let's go.
Hang on to your tidy white chocobos.
Huh?
Ah.
Right. Ready when you are.
This is gonna be fun.
Thanks, Eiko.
Nice wake-up call.
Whoa! Hey,
oh, nice. Ah, oh, rocket propelled.
Have a nice lift, guys.
That's beautiful.
I know that you're over there. I suppose you want to cross the bridge, too?
No. My business is here with you, summoner.
Nice summon.
An esper, as I thought. Look upon me now. Am I truly your enemy?
Fenrir, your place is here by my side.
As you wish, but I hope you indulge me with a better fight than that mist dragon with the other girl.
Other girl? You mean Rydia? No! What did you do to her?
Soon you will no longer care.
This is mildly messed up. Every single time I leave these people, they get messed up. They get attacked. G-forces, man. They're not that good for you. They'll knock you out.
And here, I thought gravity was the worst that could happen to us.
Meh.
Are we there yet?
You stopped halfway?
I guess not.
Boink! Boink!
Why did we just stop? Don't tell me Alexander went the back to sleep.
Yes, he did.
Oh, no. We have to do the rest of this on foot.
Looks like we have no choice.
Dude, why?
All the climbing the doors. Hoof it! Alright, we're just gonna jump in here quickly to jump across to see if there's any other champions that are worth getting. I think it's just... if this girl that's actually available as a champion also does an all attack, then I'm going to be grabbing her to replace Squall. Just because. Or at least replace Snow. I don't fucking like that dude. Never liked him.
Hello. What now?
Oh, no, wrong thing.
Touch?
Oh, it's such an itchy nose. I think somebody's picking a fight with me somewhere. Okay.
What now? Which chair?
Shulky.
Burp it up.
What now?
Absolutely nothing.
Goodbye.
Okie dokie. Oh, wrong thing. So, where are you? Where are you? Where are you, Shulky? Okay. Restore HP and remove all negative status effects. Also removes positive status effects from enemies. So she essentially replaces Refia? Yeah. Restore HP, remove stun. Okay. Remove stun. And Shulky can do all debuffs and all things. So there we go. That was a mild improvement. Is there anything worth mirage boarding on these characters either? Maybe let's see if there's anything on Tama. Oh, she's getting to the point where we might be getting close to actually getting her... Nah, she doesn't level up until we have that. So might as well grab that, and grab that, and grab that. So that's just maxed out. Stats have increased because of a sync. We'll add a custom ability. What move should I give her? What move? She has Foxfire, Stroll... Cure. So what could I give her? Be worthwhile. Wind damage? Yeah, let's go wind damage. Boom. Seed placed. Anybody else?
Take it down. Right, let's see. Where is treasure? Ooh! Resist defense down. Treasure on a raise the chance that enemies will drop rare items. That'd be nice. That'd be useful. Okay, so let's see what we got here. How far can we get? We got 1, 2, 3, 4. That's all blank space. Protect. Aha! We still have 5 left. Could spend it on one of these, which would be nice to have. And then we have 1 point left for absolutely nothing. What's that? Oh, there we go. Unlock magic jar. It can turn into magic jar. Does magic jar have anything cool? It just has... give me a elixir. Oh, guaranteed resistance to most stasis ailments. That's very useful. Nice passive skill. And reflect. Alright, so we can work our way towards that at the next stage of this one's development. But, yeah, that is kind of cool. Got that one sorted out. And now that we have that, we can put the mirror jewels onto the characters that deserve them. And, so defense plus cure Asuna. Libra Thunder Siphon. Alright, I'm finding that I'm needing to... put this on him more often than I'm actually finding on her. So, I'll probably go with that and we'll throw Asuna on with her in case we need it. That works for me. There we go. That's a nice little change. No real differences otherwise. And we'll jump ourselves back into the combat on Silver Park. That makes more sense. Haha. Alright, so we need to actually accelerate our gameplay here because I'm on a limited time scale for this last episode. It felt like it was a great idea at the time, but I'm starting to get a little bit concerned. So we're on Big Bridge. Let's get ourselves rocking and rolling. Run up the hill, run up the hill, run up the hill as fast as we can. Climbing, 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 climbing. Climbing, 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 climbing. That was unbelievably interesting. There was a lot of things going on there.
Gotcha!
Excellent. New Mirage. Oh, got the hiccups now.
I got this.
So excited I got the hiccups. Earth attacks. Okay. Earth it is. Earth Hammer! Ah, come on! Hey! What the hell? Why have I got a feeling I'm gonna have to cure him and then do it again? Oh, big stack there. Yeah. Like going like, how the hell does he have that much? Oh, right, it's somebody else. Damn. Okay, we need to throw another one of those earth hammers on him.
Okay.
All This time we'll get him. Got him! And now we just punch the crap out of the other one. Ooh, drain! I like the sound of that. I was weak to it as well. Nice.
A bovine bully who specializes in topple attacks. That club he's swinging is a force to be reckoned with. Wandered out of a labyrinth one day and never looked back.
So he's essentially going to turn into a minotaur. Okay. So what's the name of this one? Brother Tor? Brother! It's, remember, the brothers were actually the two minotaurs, from... that were Earth-based from Final Fantasy VIII. They were a summon. I don't know if brothers actually showed up as a summon in other games in the series. So... the Manotaur! I don't really need him.
You okay, Rain?
It's a long climb.
Used to go to the school way up on a hill, and it would close down even at the slightest hint of snow.
So why is that?
Because the only thing worse than climbing a slippery hill is trying to come back down.
It's true.
Dude, it's on!
Let's make this good.
Is that a magic pot? I already got you unlocked anyway, dude, so I can just beat the life out of you. So, let's just find out what you're weak against. Ha! Dark? Guess what you're going to get used. Oh, that was so nice. I need to give this guy a dark attack of some sort, because he's gone. He doesn't have any of that. Ha! I'm liking that 1200 damage. Looks good to me.
She's so upset we've moved beyond trivia.
Whew, that was a climb and a half. Yeah, we're good. Imagine you can run down the other side to get a chest. Not fucking happening. Are you serious? Got a whole other side to climb up? Really? Fuck off! That's a big game of hot process bullshit.
How are we supposed to get past here?
I'll show you.
Choco jump.
Now your turn.
Springboarded.
Thank you for the demonstration.
Yeah, thanks. Hey, no sweat.
I'm Barts. Yeah, I recognize
this
who the face
is. Is my partner Boko.
Barts and Boko!
Quick! Quick!
I like the fact that I should give Boko his own. Like, I mean, he's not just any Chocobo, he's Boko.
There's some weirdo going around here yelling my name and attacking total strangers. Wait, wait. It's not one of you, is it?
Huh?
No, we didn't even know your name until you just
not
told us.
Not at
Oh, good.
Oh.
Well, I better keep looking for him. Can't have folks like that roaming around.
If some bully was going around using my name to hurt a bunch of innocent people, I'd be the weirded out too.
I know, right?
Maybe if Tama was a tomahawk, then her name could...
Uncle! Your grade for that one is the P.U.
Yeah, that did stink.
Yeah, that
P.U.
was a bit of a stinker.
Grades.
You guys going up?
Yep. I don't even care what you gotta say, man. I'm going. I'm just climbing this hill because the hill's gonna take way too long. Literally, just whenever I give him the siphon skill, then is whenever she actually starts using her magic over and over again. Typical. Ether, ether, ether. Hi, ether. There you go. Christ, ethers are worthless in this game.
Victory!
Okay, then why don't I tag along? The more the merrier, I say.
Great. Oh. So you think I would actually have some witty repartee to actually fill in this gap now, but this is...
Right,
if I knew it was coming, I would have, but I don't... Is this Electro Behemoths? Are they worth capturing? Let's find out.
Not done yet!
The Kuza Kit. Weak against Earth. I'm weak against dark. Okay, cool. No earth items. Probably should have kept your man to actually be able to attack these things. So, yay. Remember what the hell is their actual? How do they go away? God damn, I can't actually remember. I literally only saw it like seconds ago and I completely forgotten. That's how uninteresting. Land a counterattack. That's alright. Kira, on me! Come on, attack the right guy. Nope, not the right one. Let's take a couple of turns to see if he actually attacks the right one. Nope, no retaliation. Alright, fine. Don't care. It would be nice to get one, but I'm not really feeling like that. With the counterattack being set on Rin actually having counterattack built into her kind of moveset, that's grand if I was going to get it actually to drop from her hitting, being hit, but that was going to take way too long. I mean, hopefully I get another chance for that to happen, but I'm not going to chase moves like that or chase times like that because it's just going to eat the hell out of time.
Let's
see what happens. So I can just hit these guys enough times that it actually ends up being... There we go. Oh, she countered, but she countered and killed. I actually got it to happen there. Yeah. That was actually really annoying for her to actually be around, for her to actually counter and kill him on the same hit. That was a bit crap. But what can you do?
Back when I was a kid, I heard some towns still had folks like you. But now...
God, thank God I don't have to climb the whole damn thing.
I wonder what happened to them.
Did it literally just kind of...
Me?
It just did like a halfway stop for the bridge to load.
Here is just a really good friend. You know, there are plenty of...
Oh, man. That's unbelievably irritating. Alright, let's punch the fireball. Get the maximum opportunity to hit things. Down you go. So yeah, only gonna get this guy if I actually like by any chance that they attack me in the middle of this. Adorable behemoth style cat. But I already have a behemoth in my collection.
Now that you mention it, I have seen Moogles and Chocobos wandering around Grimoire's towns.
And Captain Ferris was living with Moogles too.
Well, considering she's best buddies with a giant sea dragon, I'd say she's closer to something like a summoner or a mirage keeper.
Really? You should...
It's just the amazing intellectual deep dialogue that is interrupted by these events. It's terrible. I'm getting salty. This game does have moments that feel like it doesn't need to be this long. You didn't need to do it this way. I mean, if they had carried us halfway up and then we had to climb the last quarter of this, and rather than what appears to be that I'm going to finish this and then have to do another set of this, and I'm going to be pissed to do it.
Victory!
I'm glad you're happy. It's another empty victory on the way to hell.
Really? Really? You sure know some interesting people.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Please. Don't be the most boring game on the planet for no apparent reason. There's no need for that. Zoom, jump, climb. At least we're guaranteed to know that this is the end. That's the one benefit. What the hell is that? Showed you these guard across. You can use these to get past enemy blockades, so keep an eye open. Alright. So that's what we need to do. We need to get to that platform so we can get over them.
What is that supposed to mean? We need to get that mirage out of the way.
That is awesome. I'm glad I didn't have to do it a number of times. I got it in the first try.
Let's begin.
Oh no, there's three of them. All right, let's see. What kind of guys are these? Let me please, please, please be able to use lightning on them. Or copper. Weak against lightning, weak against wind. Yeah, I can work with that. Weak against anything else? Confusion. But lightning and wind, bam, I'm happy days. Alright, so what we got? So we're throwing some thunder out of the sky. Boom, happy days. What we need to know now is how much damage that does. Whoa! And he does a fair amount himself. And we actually have... Wait, I thought I had arrow as well. Either way, not that brilliant, but we'll cast Acura on her to get her healed up, because I don't want to actually be anywhere near done with the health that we have. Death. Oh, nice. This might actually do some good damage. Oh! I was up there. What was the prism opportunity again? I wish you could bring it up again without having to lose a turn. Magical enhancements. Alright, so we're just going to throw protect on this dude. And actually give him the last one. Easily done, easily done. We've easily got these old guys done. Easily done, easily done. We've got of all these guys easily done. Oh, it takes five to do that. All right, well. Oh, that's curious. What happened to her? Oh no, Siphon's on the other dude now. God damn it. I'm gonna give this guy his dream a try. Well, at least, it's like the idea of it actually works. If it was actually better, it would give me more stuff, but... Ow! Well, he needs a wobble stopper. Ain't no wobble on me. And you need to take an item. And throw it at these guys. So what one can we throw on them? A small amount of that? No. Got to have something better than that. Boom! Wind damage. See, we can just use those items to kind of like fill with our turns until we actually build up some. This is the fact trying to figure out which ones actually are related to the right kind of damage. But we can just do that until we can gather up our AP again to be able to use it for spells and whatever else. There you go. Stay down. Abilities, and what kind of boost do I have for him? And give him faith. And we'll get him this time. Oh, crap! Nope! Don't like that! Woo! Did not want to actually have him all powered up from all the stuff I was cast on him to then immediately turn around and kick my ass. That would not have ended well. Right. Well, that was slightly terrifying. Okay, so he's a large, he goes with a copper gnome, he turns into this. What interesting stuff you got. Mithril Giant, Shell Sling, Stabilizer Smash, Victory Charge. Yeah. Really got none that interests me, to be honest, dude. Name your Mirage, though. Mithril Giant. Mithril Giant. Al Elric. Yeah, Alphonse Elric. That works for me. Does It's just the fact that it makes me think of, like, the enchanted empty armor, which is Alphonse Elric. No, well, you'll be going and staying with Seraphie. I'm sure she'll find a useful... find a use for such a big, strapping young guy. Whenever she's not planning the murder of mirages with those evil dead eyes. Fall over. You're dead. Bye-bye.
Oh,
good.
Direction. I think I will need to take some classes in Lanese.
Lanese? So essentially, did he mispronounce the obstruction? Did he call him an obstetrician? I don't know.
Hey, listen, sis.
You know that expression, cross that bridge when you come to it? Don't you think... I mean, it's not like you can cross a bridge before you come to it. It doesn't make any sense. If you ask me.
I didn't. Please make it stop.
I'm gonna get wheeled by this one.
Okay, here.
God, three of them? Really? That's a bit much to actually drop three of them every single time I'm going to run into these guys. Feels very slow. Especially if I'm not going to have all that much AP to work with between each of these fights. This is going to take forever. Oh, screw your shells. Don't care. Just wanted to actually get them out of the way a little bit faster, because I'm kind of getting to the point where I kind of get to these points whenever I'm playing this game. There's definitely a sense of, oh, you just let me through already. I'm not underpowered. I'm not wrong. I'm not doing the wrong attacks. It's just that you're purposely making these guys unnecessarily slow and awkward. Oh, battery's dead. Hang on a second, we'll just need to swap controllers. Okay. Breaking the fourth wall. Okay, I got a mild electric shock from that. That wasn't good. Something actually knocked out the TV and gave me an electric shock from that last action. I need to find out what the hell that was. We'll sort that out outside of this particular situation. Oh, what did I do? What did I do? Oh, no. Well, let's give this Mega Evolution a try again. We haven't used it in a while. There's a reason why it hasn't really been that effective as of late. But maybe this might work. There's a lot of all attacks, and I do have thunder in this. So maybe. Thunderbolt. Strike them down. Nope, nowhere near enough. That's what it was, just so I could do two attacks, and then left me with absolutely nothing I can use against these guys. So useful, isn't it? Didn't I already attack these guys with ice? Go down! I do love this auto-battling methodology. It works so well, doesn't it? It makes you feel wonderfully engaged with the combat of the game.
Yeah!
That wasn't so bad.
So Useless Dog has since he failed us again, although we did manage to take one of them down and whittled down the others with a mild amount of damage, but it's just the fact his AP cost is so high for so little damage. Not worth it. Oh, shit. Oh, come on! Didn't know whether or not I had to pull right, back or pull forward because I didn't know I'd gotten hit by the last one. Oh, Jesus Christ. Now we found a pattern. Boom, done, dusted again. It's getting to the point now where I really, really want this battle and this climb of this goddamn bridge to end. And I hope the fight at the top is worthwhile getting all these level boosts. But otherwise, this is going to drive me around the bend. Whoop, up and over we go. We got him. Got him. So I was actually just doing this now to gain AP, which is really is the biggest problem. I think I need to actually start investing large amounts of money on Aether. Aether is the biggest issue in this, actually having enough AP to be able to do the things that you want to do. Get you healed up. Get you healed up. So literally I'm spending 5 turns of AP to get myself to the point of actually being able to attack them for another 5 goddamn turns. It's a little bit ridiculous. They're mithril giants, but they're also a pain in the ass. Can't believe I fought the whole damn thing.
This is it!
Okay, so he's shelling up, so I can't really do as much damage to him with the magic anyway, so we'll just have to pummel him instead. Yeah, you say, you shell up as much as you want, buddy. But it's not going to stop me from hitting you as hard as I can. It only reflects magic.
We did it!
Victory!
Remedies, super useful. Now that I have a Suna. Make sure there's no other guy up there sending down more for me to fight. That would just be a goddamn annoying. Okay, so we have our save point here. Of course, we're going to be running the boss very, very shortly. So we get our heal, we get our save, and then we go in and punch the light side of things.
Pummel them to death!
Bum 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 bum. Just to make sure, we had to have one more set of mithril giants for me to punch.
Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening them.
Let's just continue this pattern of beatdown. Oh, switch to her just punching. Why was that? Down he goes.
No trouble at all.
Predictable.
Van Dabby Dozy. So I'm just gonna wander back down and get a free heal and then head on to our boss. Weird. It's not gonna make me go back down and light all these goddamn pillars, is it? Wait, what's this down here to the right? Sort of mild curiosity. Oh, it's just a weird part of the architecture. I was like, looking at it, going like, why? There's not even showing a box or like a guy down there or anything. Why am I wasting time with investigations? I'm here to play story and story only. Let's get back to it. Adorable Gilgamesh. So cute!
And you are?
You are?
Huh? You mean you don't recognize him?
I have awaited this day. How many years now?
I don't know. How many realities have you been wandering through as well, Gilgamesh?
What was I going to do to you again?
Hey.
Fight him?
Don't look at me.
Tell me what you know.
Huh? Nobody asks me that.
Yes, because you know nothing.
I can't look away.
Your full name is actually Lan Jon Snow.
I'll get it right this time. I have awaited this day 100 years.
Oh, well, that's a nice round number.
Sure is, for one he just made up.
Very the lame.
Yeah, I'll say.
Quiet, quiet, quiet! No one is permitted to mock the almighty Gilgamesh! Not without a fight.
Okay, bring it on, Gilgamesh. Let's see what you got, legendary
How
swordsman.
How old does this guy have to be if he's been waiting 100...
Oh, you know as well as I do, there's this thing called hyperbole. Like when people say, this book weighs a ton, or,
oh, I could sleep for a month.
Oh, hyperbole. As in, hyperbole could eat the whole chocobo.
Is he the serious?
I hope he's not serious. Or else Bartz is going to have to hyperbole in fast.
The battle on the bridge.
Here I am.
Here I am.
I'll take it from here.
Slice to the face, slice to the face, slice to the face, slash! And Lionheart! Which, to be honest, this is kind of like a weakened version of Lionheart is like wop 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 straight through the person at the end. A lot of damage. I like it. Do like the cloud music or the squall music as well. Like if I'm playing through this in after game, I might actually just put that on as the battle music at all times. So what are we going with here? We had nothing we could do to him. There is nothing that was actually going to do massive damage, really. And he doesn't really take to status effects that well, so I think our only option is to try a poison nail. With random chance we might have actually tried to poison him. But everything else outside of that is going to be... Oh man, I don't have like real dark damage. Try this to bring down his defense. And it looks pretty good. It does about 1200 damage. And you can go with poison needles again. Nah, not gonna poison him with this, but it was worth a try. Go back to armor piercer again. Boom! More 1100. Jesus Christ! You know what I'm gonna go with? Guess who's going to actually get all of his buffs taken off of him? Also, I get to see Shelky's thing for. I don't know, because I haven't seen it before. Ooh. You digital acting angry badass?
Counterattack.
Activated.
Let's get this started, kids! Oh, now you're asking for it! So long!
Dude! One damage? Ha! Ha! He took out Excalibur instead of Excalibur. Wrong choice, shithead! Wrong choice indeed. Yeah, so what we're going to do is... Right claw again. Still pretty weak. Oh, she needs to have time to recover that. Maybe we'll just speed that up a little touch. Oh! 563 just? Just whittling them down. That's all we can do. Oh, shit. Nope, that's not the right one.
Oh, now you're asking for it!
That's me dead. Yeah, that's not what I wanted to have happen. So you just kind of hope that he actually gets Excalibur. Wake up, wake up, wake up! Just realize, if I actually separated out before he turned, went and did that, he would only kill one out of my stack. Never thought about that. Sweep the lake, Johnny. Did I get him?
Well,
yeah, that's him got. Down goes the mightiest Gilgamesh. In all its cute little glory. So the Battle of the Big Bridge wasn't all that big of a battle as long as he did not get Excalibur back to back.
You! Don't up on me like that, cowards! Bugs!
What?
Next time, it's just you and me.
That's definitely
definitely happened.
Quit!
Well, I've given you enough of a beating anyway.
Ha! Good day!
Fly away with your green chicken friend.
I bid you good day. I said good day.
So, who mixed up his marbles?
No, they took them.
Not me.
Well, at least he's out of our hair, I guess.
Great.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Don't know who the hell. I don't know why. But just so we can have a battle with him. Bart's champion medal has been unlocked. So, why? Why is this actually the characters that interest me less than the actual characters that are showing up against us? I mean, why no Vivi? Why no Gilgamesh? Especially if Excalibur was actually a choice. If I could use champion and just kill any boss with Excalibur, hell yes. But, yeah. That appears to be the end of another chapter. Guys, that actually was a bit of a slog to get up that hill. Essentially, it was just the Clash on the Big Bridge with the Clash on the Big Bridge music, with Gilgamesh in hand, with his goofy, silly self available to fight against. That was actually quite enjoyable. I'm just going to need to check for something, or am I actually sitting here? There we go. Couldn't find someone whenever I was sitting here in the chair. Anyway. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. This has been another chapter of World of Final Fantasy. This has been chapter 16, I think. So we're down to 5 chapters left of the game. This will be me for this session. Of course, you won't even notice the difference because there'll be another episode up as expected as soon as this is available. But of course, we're trying to get these all done before the 29th of November for the Final Fantasy 15 release. So we will continue to hammer on. We will get this done. And I hope to see you all in another episode. Of course, if you enjoyed this episode, you can hit the wee subscribe button that's popped up there. Or you can actually check over the list over here on the side of previous episodes of the series, the playlist, and other things that are available on the channel. If you enjoyed it, make sure to subscribe because you can get plenty of content here from Passage of Skin in the future, and until the next time, I will see you all. Bye-bye.